Narane was one of the earliest settlements around the East African coast. Narane measures about 6.3 acres of land, and it was started in the 13th century. In other settlements, like Gede, we don't have a madras in this site. So Narane, actually, we boast to say that Islamic education was introduced from here. This is coastal vegetation that is found here, because we are only 100 meters from the ocean. This is a mihrab of the great mosque found at Narane site. And the mihrab has five steps. It's the only mihrab with Islamic inscription. This makes us very proud of Narane. During that era, we didn't have cement. But then the inhabitants of Narane, they used to take coral reef from the ocean, produce local lime at the site, and use this lime for construction purpose. And that's why up to date, these structures are still standing. This type of coral is very light, but then very hard and easy to shape. Because from 1825, when this mosque was constructed, up to that, some of its fixtures are still, like, I think you can see the corner, it's very sharp. This point is higher on a cliff, about very high. You can see an intruder to this point. So it's strategically situated and very, very, I think they consider security as a very main factor. Not forgetting the creek anyway, which was very conducive for transportation, for communication purposes. The creek also offered a natural harbor for the people who stayed here. And not forgetting seafood. The pillar measures 9.4 meters, its height, and it's octagonal in shape. It has eight corners. So it's very unique, because we have a number of pillars around the coast, but then this one is very different from all the other pillars in the region. The word of this area is called Mnara. It's called Mnarani because of this pillar. This is a grave. The way it is constructed, actually, it tells the people who used to live here, they used to live a very, very high-class life. This one is for three soldiers who were buried here. And this information came from the excavation work, which was done by James Kirkman when he came and did the excavation at this site. So three soldiers were buried in this grave. Narane is a ruin because it was a city abandoned and the structures collapsed, so we have ruins. But then up to date, we have it's still in use. It's a living it has living institution that is being used by the local people. Like this area, every week, maybe I can say every weekend, mostly have people who are coming here to perform traditional rituals, because the local people here associate the baobab tree with spirits. Narane is a product of interaction, where people moved from one area to another, interacting in different activities because of different reasons. So in my view, I may say globalization started a long time ago.